السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and welcome back. Today, inshallah, we're going to discuss another very precious sunnah with great virtue. The sunnah of shaking hands upon meeting. Not necessarily because you know the person, not necessarily because you need to address him or her in a particular matter, but listen to this hadith, which is narrated by Al-Bara ibn Azib, may Allah be pleased with him, and it is a sound hadith. In which the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, ما من مسلمين يلتقيان فيتصافحان إلا غفر لهما قبل أن يتفرقا. Whenever two Muslims meet, I was on my way and he is on his way, so come across each other. السلام عليكم, brother Muhammad. السلام عليكم, Mike. How are you? And then we shake hands. While we're shaking hands, all our minor sins will be wiped out. They will be all forgiven before we leave. What? Is it possible? This is what the Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith. But before we leave it to another point, I would like to bring to our attention a few facts. Fact number one. Shaking hands with a woman who's not your mahram is absolutely forbidden. And it's even a major sin. You don't say, cool, Sheikh, mashallah, this is the kind of Sheikh that we want. He said that every time you meet somebody and you shake hands, your sins will be forgiven. What about if you give a kiss and a hug too? What? A woman who's not your sister, who's not your wife, who's not your daughter, who's not your mother, who's not your aunt, paternal or maternal, you're not allowed to touch. Not even shaking hands. She's my student. She is my patient. She is my client. She's my own secretary. She is the principal of my school. The Prophet ﷺ's hand never ever touched the hand of a woman who's not lawful for him. Aisha radiallahu anha narrated so. And you know, in the past, there was a practice of bay'ah. When somebody accepts Islam, and on the day of the conquest of Mecca and during the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, Muslims came forward to give the Prophet ﷺ what is known as bay'ah or the Pledge of Allegiance. So on the day of Al-Hudaybiyah, on the day of the conquest of Mecca, all men came to the Prophet ﷺ and shook hands with him one after another to give him the bay'ah, and he accepted that from them. What about women? The bay'ah. How did he accept the bay'ah from them verbally? Bay'anaka ya Rasulallah. We give you the pledge of allegiance of O Prophet of Allah verbally. And he says, I accept. No shaking hands, even though he's a messenger of Allah. So when it comes to the matter of shaking hands, men and women who are not mahram to each other and permanent mahram, the brother-in-law is not a mahram. Hasn't she? No, they're not mahram. How come? Because if somebody is married to a woman and this woman happened to either die or they got divorced after the iddah, can he marry her sister? It is perfectly permissible in Islam. Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu was married to Ruqayyah, the Prophet's daughter, may Allah be pleased with her. On the second year after Hijrah, she passed away. And then the Prophet ﷺ offered him Umm Kulthum to marry. And he married to Umm Kulthum, Ruqayya's sister. That's perfectly fine. So if it is possible to marry any woman, even if you're not married to her, if it is possible to marry her in the future, then she's not mahram. What about my mother-in-law? She's a permanent mahram. You can shake hands with her. You can travel with her. You can be alone with her. But I'm talking about when I meet with another man. And I see him, he says, Assalamu alaikum, wait a minute. And I shake hands with him with this intention. all our sins, me and him, will fall from between our hands. غفر لهما. Before they leave. Before Islam, the Jews and the Christians and the Meccan pagans used to have a tradition of greeting each other by the hand, sometimes by one finger or four, a few fingers, or by the palm like this, without verbally greeting. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تشبهوا. Do not act like those people. Our greeting is as-salam, to say as-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. But it was narrated before that the Prophet ﷺ waved to some women, but he also waved and he said, As-salamu alaykum. So a combination of both is perfectly fine. But it is very common. You're in your vehicle and you see somebody, like, you know, this is, hello, hi. Or you want to say, As-salamu alaykum. This is not permissible. This is disliked. Makruh in Islam. But if say, hey, salamu alaykum, so used your hand and verbally greeted him or her, you were worded. Also, brothers and sisters, remember that the Prophet ﷺ was observed when he arrived to Medina. Abdullah ibn Salam was a former Jewish rabbi and a highly educated and well-versed person before Islam and after Islam. Before Islam, in Judaism, he was a very well-versed Jewish rabbi, and after Islam, he was also educated in the deen of Islam. He said, when the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, arrived to Medina, I was among those who went to receive him to find out whether he is genuine or a faker. So what I heard from him first made me believe that he's indeed the final Messenger of Allah. He said the first words came out of his mouth when he arrived to Medina, أيها الناس أفشوا السلام وأطعموا الطعام وصلوا بالليل والناس نيام تدخلوا جنة ربكم بسلام. What did he say in English, please? He said, oh people, first teaching, he taught people in Medina, أفشوا السلام, spread the greeting of peace. ألقي السلام على من عرفت ومن لم تعرف من المسلمين. I do not necessarily have to know this brother or this guard or this driver or this conductor or this teacher or this client. I enter some place and say, I know there are Muslims. Assalamu alaikum, you all. And it would be better to say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And if you say otherwise, it's also permissible, but this is more rewarded. So when you greet Muslims, you're automatically rewarded. Assalamu alaikum, 10 good deeds. You add wa rahmatullah, another 10 good deeds. Wa barakatuhu, another 10 good deeds. So when you say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, 30 good deeds. And Allah the Almighty said in Surah An-Nisa, إِذَا حُيِّيتُم بِتَحِيَّةٍ فَحَيُّوا بِأَحْسَنَ مِنْهَا أَوْ رُدُّوهَا. So if it is me recommended for a person to take the initiative and to greet others, Assalamu alaikum, you guys, it becomes obligatory upon those who have been greeted to respond saying, Wa alaikum assalam, either with a similar one, or it is better to increase the greeting saying, Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So my dear viewers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ooh,